Now, let us go through different methods of concrete curing. Curing methods can be broadly classified into following categories. First one, water curing. Second, membrane curing. Third one, hygroscopic curing. And fourth one is thermal curing. Now, let us see the curing methods one by one. First one is water curing. This is the best method of curing since it satisfies all the criteria required, like absorption of heat of hydration, prevention of shrinkage, and in facilitating hydration reaction. Different methods which are used under water curing are, first one is sprinkling. Water is sprinkled using pipes over the concrete surface several times a day, keeping the surface wet. Just see here, this is called sprinkling. Second one is ponding. The horizontal concrete surfaces like slabs, floorings, concrete road surfaces, which are cured by stagnating water, creating barriers on all the four sides. This type of curing is called ponding, where water is stagnated by creating barriers on all the four sides. Third one is covering. The surface of the concrete is covered by certain materials like gunny bags, hessian cloth, paddy straws, etc., which has the quality of retaining water in them. They are periodically wetted to prevent the evaporation of water. Just see here, these columns were covered by hessian cloth, which were wetted in a certain time interval. Okay, this is called covering. Fourth one is immersing. Precast concrete products are cured by immersing them in water. They are kept in the water till the curing period is over. These are the concrete cubes which are cured by keeping them in water for a required period of time, like 7 days, 14 days, 21 days, okay, like that. All the precast concrete products also, like pavers, concrete poles, RCC windows, are all cured in this way. Now the second one is membrane curing. Here the concrete is covered by impervious membrane, which will effectively prevent and seal off the evaporation of water from concrete. Some of the materials which are used for this method are bituminous compounds, wax emulsions, polyester films, rubber compounds, etc. Just see here, this is polyester film. The concrete surface is sealed off using these types of materials so that the water will not get evaporated from the concrete. This type of method is used where there is a scarcity of water. Okay, but this method is not efficient as that of water curing. Third one is hygroscopic curing. In this method, hygroscopic compounds like calcium chloride is applied over the surface of the concrete. Hygroscopic means the compounds which has the ability to absorb water from the atmosphere. Calcium chloride has that quality. So when it is applied over the concrete surface, it absorbs atmospheric moisture and concrete will be kept wet. This procedure is rarely used nowadays. Fourth one is thermal curing. Concrete is subjected to heat from within or from outside so that curing process accelerates, resulting in hot setting. When the wet concrete is heated, the curing gets accelerated. The time period required for curing will be minimize. Let us see the different methods which are used in thermal curing. First one is steam curing. Here, steam is applied to the concrete to achieve accelerated curing to gain high early strength. This process is carried out in two ways. In the first method, concrete is cured in normal atmospheric pressure. Okay, and in second method, the concrete product is placed in a closed chamber where high temperature and pressure is applied through steam. This is the closed chamber where the concrete products were kept inside, and in this chamber when the steam is passed due to high temperature and pressure, the concrete products get cured within 24 hours. Normally for AAC blocks, this type of procedure is used. Second, electrical curing. Heat is applied to the concrete using blankets from outside, or electrodes is used to provide heat from within the concrete. This is the blanket which is spread over the concrete, and when electric current is passed, this blanket gets heated up so that the curing process gets accelerated. Here, the electrodes were connected to the steel bars from within so that concrete gets heated from inside. These types of curing is used in cold weather regions where, due to the cold climate, the curing process takes a much longer time. Third one is infrared or ultraviolet curing. Here, concrete gets its curing temperature through infrared or ultraviolet radiation. See, this is ultraviolet curing. Due to the heat generated, same like electric curing, the concrete gets cured. If you like my videos, please subscribe to my channel and press the like button. Okay, thank you. Bye bye.